Hi, in this video, I will explain you how you can filter your data based on the user location. This video is based on Visual Analytics 8.5, but you can also reproduce it starting from 8.2 release. I will show you how you can create the report. So we have now the VA interface. I will select some data that I've loaded upfront. The data is called geolocation. I'm loading the data. I will create a list table. In that list table, I will add some columns, the country name, and a few years. This dataset contains the country name, the country code, and data about the number of inhabitants across multiple years. I will go for every 10 years in this report. This is not the objective to analyze the data. You can see that we have data based on the country name and the information for every year. I will add a data-driven content object. This data-driven content object is used to display an HTML page, and that HTML page will filter out the data based on the user location and pass the filter to the list table. We'll define the country code here. You see the country code. What I will do based on the data-driven content object is filter the list table. We'll just check that it works as expected. So this is filtering out the data. I will reduce that page, that tops. This is out of the box, but what we want to do is get a bit more information and a bit more possibilities. So I will specify my web application server. I'm using HTTPS because it requires a specific authorization, and the name of my web application or my web page is basically geolocation. As you see, I automatically get a prompt from the browser to allow or block the usage of the location. I will use allow, and behind the scene, the connection is done, retrieving my location, and based on that, filtering the data. As you can see over here, my current country is Belgium, and I can only see the data from Belgium. So how are we doing this? We are first creating an HTML page, and this HTML page has a few information. The first thing to do is to define two scripts that are available on GitHub. Those files are provided by SAS, and they are available to ease the development of data-driven content object. Then I'm specifying in the body a paragraph, and the paragraph has an ID of demo. This is the paragraph that will display the current location. Then we have defined three different functions. The first one is the function show error. This function is basically looking at the browser information and displaying information based on if the users are allowed to use location, yes or no, which is fine. We are using the sent on data received callback function. This is a function that is available inside the two JavaScript files that we have defined earlier. We are then calling, when we receive data, the filter function. The filter function is defined here. It's getting the message from VA, getting result, out of the result retrieving data, and then executing a function called navigator geolocation get current position. This is a default JavaScript function that is available in the browser. When we are getting the current position, we show the error, as we've seen over here, if it's not allowed, or we execute the show country name function. What is defined in this function? So you have the show country name function. It's passing the information about the position. We are connecting to a web server that is outside of SAS and that is available at OpenStreetMap. This application will just convert your position to a real name, a country in this case. So we will pass a few parameters like position and coordinates for latitude, coordinates for longitude, and the level of details is 1. We are calling that URL that we are generating here. And then when we receive the feedback from that request, we execute a function that will parse the JSON file, so the answer that the response that we are getting from the web server. And we are defining a selection object. The selection object will be filtering back the data in the VA report. So what we will get here is a list of country codes. We will convert those country codes to uppercase and filter the data from VA result, the result that we got from the VA report object, and filter based on the selection object that we have just defined, with which contains the country code. What we will display in the paragraph demo is just a bit of HTML specifying which current country we are from and the data address.country that we have just retrieved from the web application OpenStreetMap. In order to execute this, we need to load it. We have 2 possibilities, or we load it on a specific web application server. In this case, we will have to define the course options using SAS Environment Manager to allow access from an external server. Otherwise, we can use the web server that is available with VIA. This is the solution that we will use here. So with VIA, we have a web server, and the web server is configured to execute any HTML. So we will push the code that we have under our server, on the my code, the geolocation code. We'll push that to the va8.5 gel.sas.com domain under the var.www HTML folder. We are done with the demo. Where should you go from here? We have additional resources, the documentation about Visual Analytics 8.5, where you can get information about data-driven content object. We have also the third-party visualization on GitHub. This is where the 2 JavaScript files are coming from. If you are using your own web server instead of the one provided with SAS VIA, you can get information about configuring the cross-origin resource sharing using the communities.sas.com link here under. If you want to get other examples about using data-driven content objects, you can refer to Day3JS blogs that are available on the SAS communities. Thank you for your attention, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.